Nā hoa makamaka a kanaʻi au puni mai ka piʻina a ka lā i kumukahi a i ke kaulana ma ka mole ʻole hua. Aloha pumehana iā kākou apau. Mahalo nui loa no ka hele ana mai. O ma ka lāpua langa ke koʻu inoa, aia o ma ka papa umi kumalua ma ke kulaki ʻekie. Welcome everyone to our beginning of the year convocation. My name is Makalapua Longake and I am a senior at our high school. We have gathered here today to honor Ke Akua Manalua, our beloved Ke Alii Pauahi, and to bless our new school year together. This year's spiritual theme is Ua Ola Loko I Ke Aloha, Love Gives Life Within. O keia ka ka kou ka hea I ka haipule, mai ka puke o halelu mo kuna eiva, pauku e kahi a elua. E hoʻonani aku au iā ʻoe e Yehova, me koʻuna au apau. E heluhelu aku au I kau mauhana kūpaianaha apau. E oliʻoli no au, a e hauʻoli no hoʻi iā ʻoe. E hoʻoleʻa aku hoʻi au I kou inoa. E ka mea kiʻekiʻe loa. Our call to worship is taken from Psalm 9, verses 1 and 2. I will give thanks to you, Lord, with all my heart. I will tell of all your wonderful deeds. I will be glad and rejoice in you. I will sing the praises of your name, O Most High. E pule kako. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this day, and thank you for the time that you have given us to be with you and each other. We thank you, Lord, for all that you have blessed us with up until this very moment. Lord, I ask that you bless each and every person here, that they may find peace, wisdom, courage, strength, and perseverance within themselves this school year. I ask that as you instill these godly gifts within each person, that you give every one of them the opportunity to build upon it. Because, Lord, you have already said that we are fearfully and wonderfully made. So I ask that you help in ensuring that every heart believes that. And I ask that you help them to believe that they were made in the image of perfection and that they are capable of doing all things with you. We ask these things in your holy and precious name. Amen.
Aloha, and welcome back to New School Year. As we look forward to getting back into the classrooms, back into our offices, we want to make sure that we turn to the right source for strength as we go through this time. And that's to Ke Akua, to look at his word and to see what it is that he has to share with us. Nakahu would like to share with you our spiritual theme for this year so that we might find guidance and protection over all of us. I'm going to turn to Kahu Kanaloa now to share today's scripture.
Mai ka puke o Luka. Makuna umi pauku I wakalua kumahiku a I wakalua kumuwalu. Hai akula ke kaka o lelo I aku. E aloha aku oe I ka haku I kou a kua, me kou na au a pau, a me kou uhane a pau, au me kou I kaika a pau, a me kou manao a pau, a I kou hoa launa e liki me oe iho. I maila, oia iaia, ua haʻipolole mai nei oe, o kau ia e ahanai ai e ola no oe. Our scripture reading is taken from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 10, verses 27 through 28. Dr. Luke records a conversation between a person of the law and Jesus. The person asks, how you can inherit eternal life? To which Jesus poses this question to the lawyer. What does the law say? The lawyer answers, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your strength, and with all your mind, and love your neighbor as yourself. You have answered correctly, Jesus replied. Do this, and you will live. This year's spiritual theme, Wa'ola Loko Ike Aloha, translates to love gives life within. This Olelo No'eau supports God's word about loving your neighbor as you love yourself. The question is, who is our neighbor? Are our family members our neighbors or our friends? Jesus tells the story of the Good Samaritan, who while traveling sees a person who has been beaten, robbed, and left on the side of the road. He cares for the man, takes him to the nearest town, pays for him to be cared for before he, the Samaritan, continues his journey. Was this beaten man a friend? No, he was a total stranger, and he belonged to a culture that scrutinized the Samaritan. However, the Samaritan man did not limit his choice of who his neighbor was. Instead, he did not see the man's race, skin color, gender, or appearance. He only saw a beaten man in need of help.
Like our Princess Poi, he used her immense wealth to tackle social injustice issues by creating the Kamehameha schools for our benefit, her people. We too should learn to tend to those in need. Our Princess, brilliant Uwivi leader of great honor and mercy, did not seek self-promotion, but instead sought to develop and train Kanaka to become Kupono and Pa'ahana.
Here is a truth that will surely bless you. Take the time this year to focus on helping those people in need. Love your neighbors by supporting organizations that feed the hungry, who tend to the needy, who care for those people who are not as equipped to fend for themselves. This one mighty act of sacrificial love will center you in goodness and provide a lifetime of blessings to you and to your family. Because loving brings forth a state of Eola that begins from within.
As we prepare to open up our respective schools for a full year of educational service to our brilliant keiki, there is one more act of aloha that is a foundational commitment for all. Jesus teaches us to prioritize our relationship building with Nakeiki. In Mark 9:36-37, we read, put a child in the middle of the room, then cradling the little one in his arms, he said, whoever embraces one of these children, as I do, embraces me, and far more than me, God who sent me.
This beautiful imagery further illustrates our Lord's care over our children and their well-being. Our classrooms are sacred places of encouragement and empowerment. Even when things seemingly are going off the rails, God's perspective is that when we care for our students, we are caring for Keaku.
Lord God Almighty, we worship you and we ask your blessings of protection, wisdom, and success for all of us here at Kamehameha School. We humbly ask that our students, Na Hauma, our staff, Na Kumu, Na Limahana, our leaders, Na Alakai, and our parents, Na Makua, flourish this year as we continue to love you and learn how to love one another. ASU, we also ask for an extra measure of faith and unified commitment to help as we begin this new school year. Help us to be wise in all that we say and do, and may our love reflect your brilliance and heal our land. Ma'akai noa kau keiki niwa hiwa, in the blessed name of Jesus Christ, your Son. Amen, amen, amen.
Aloha mai kako. This year's spiritual theme is Ua Ola Loko Iki Aloha. Love gives life within. That means that whether you are the giver or the receiver of aloha, both will have ola from the inside. And ola is health, it is life, it is well-being, it is healing. So when I think about that kind of aloha, I think about when God gave life to Adam, the first human, the first kane. And he did that by breathing life's breath, or the living breath, into his iwu, into his alo, that aloha, yeah, was that first act of aloha that gave literal life to Adam, physical life to Adam, yeah, to his body, and caused him to be alive. And then I also think about God's love through Jesus, and that we are not just a body with physical life, but we also have a spiritual life, and that is a soul that we have. It's eternal, it lives forever. But I think about this life on earth right now, and I think about the love of Jesus and what he did on the cross for us, and the gift of abundant life on this earth, that overflowing life, that life that is more than enough while we're here on earth. And it didn't mean money or fame or popularity or stuff. That kind of abundant life was actually ola. Ola to our inner self, our heart, our na'au. It is emotional, mental, and spiritual ola. So with all of that mana'o about aloha and ola, I had this kona ike then, right? This perspective that where there is love, where there is aloha, there has to be evidence of life. There has to be evidence of health and just well-being and healing and goodness. But then it must be also true then, if no more, right? If there is no aloha in a place, in a person, something, in a situation, then we will see the opposite. There is no ola there. There will be probably no well-being, the opposite of health, right? Okay, so when we do though, when we do aloha kekahi kekahi, aloha aina, aloha ikeakua, there will be signs of life. Cannot help it. It's just an outcome that will come automatic when that's going on. We are actually giving life to each other and to ourselves and all of God's creation in the action of love, in the action of aloha. But how then do we do this aloha well without feeling like we're doing too much, or we're feeling overwhelmed, or we're feeling so drained that we're giving out, but we are not feeling filled ourselves? So I'm going to encourage you this year to take this perspective about aloha. Love without expectation. Love without expectation. And that's not easy. That's not easy. But if we do love expecting to get love back, and we don't, or we give something and we don't get the mahalo that we wanted, or we do something well and we get no recognition for it, we might feel drained. Yeah, we might feel empty or upset and hurt, angry, and maybe less likely to do that hono or good thing again. But when we aloha and do good things without expecting anything in return, yeah, we don't get disappointed. So aloha just to aloha. Malama just to malama. Kokua just to kokua. Be kind just to be kind. Forgive just to forgive. Yeah, and when we do this, because that's the way Kiakua, that's the way Jesus loves. A love without expectation of return. It's just love. When we do this, we will keep the aloha inside of us at full capacity, because the source of aloha and of ola itself is God, and God never runs out. So let's stay connected to that source, that kumu, yeah, the kumu, the overflowing fountain of aloha and ola, and really love without expectation this year. And if we do that well, if we do that well, eka ohana, we will see signs of overflowing life, well-being, health, and healing, ola, everywhere. Amene, and God bless you this year.
When Jesus told this parable, this mo'olelo, this story of the Good Samaritan, he highlighted a person who had chosen to both show and share aloha with an injured stranger. Yet in contrast, he mentioned two others, a religious leader and another with a strong family background, who also passed by, but neither of these men stopped to help the one in need. You see, our status, our title, our beliefs, and our history do not mean that we always show and share aloha. As KS Haumana, you are blessed with lessons, resources, and kumu who encourage you to show and share aloha with those around you. Yet being a KS Haumana doesn't mean you automatically do this. It's a conscious, personal decision you make every day. The families you come from and the ohana that you have don't automatically mean you show and share aloha. It's a conscious, personal decision you make every day. The Samaritans were actually outcasts in this area, but that didn't matter to this Samaritan who encountered a hurt stranger on the road and helped him regardless of their differences. Jesus told this story for a reason. He showed us that love should lead to action and that the differences between us shouldn't get in the way. When we encounter hurt, let's respond with aloha. It matters to God. It is needed in this world. It builds our character and who we're becoming in the future. It's also how we'll want to be treated if the roles are one day reversed. Perhaps as you reflect on your life, you have already been the recipient of Good Samaritans who went out of their way to show and share aloha with you. As we are beginning a new year at school, adjusting to changes and challenges all around, interacting with our ohana, and participating in our community, how will we choose to show and share aloha? Let's follow the example of the Good Samaritan, who didn't let differences get in the way and gave aloha to a hurting stranger in his path. What would the story have looked like if he stopped with good intentions but never acted on them? Aloha is not always the easiest response, but when we choose to show it with our lives and share it with others, we have an opportunity to do something that is truly good.
If we are wise, we know that
Aloha mai kākou e ngā pua o Kamehameha. As we enter this new school year, there has been a heightened concern for the health and well-being of our families, our students, and our staff. Due to the sharp increase in COVID cases here in Hawaii these past few weeks, it has caused serious apprehensions among state and county officials about setting new safety standards. The rise in COVID cases has even triggered frontline medical doctors to determine that our hospitals will face overcrowding if the current rate of infection lasts for more than a month. The key question is, what path do we take? In Psalm 32:8, the Lord says, "I will guide you along the best pathway for your life. I will advise you and watch over you." Aren't those comforting words? They are for me. You see, I'm always trying to follow God's wisdom so I can make the right decisions. Decisions that impact my family's well-being, my friends, and those people who God puts in my path. That yearning to follow Jesus' direction keeps me focused on what God is doing in my life. I usually receive great clarity when keeping my footsteps aligned with Jesus and the Holy Spirit. And when I follow the Lord's path for me, I make better choices. This year's spiritual theme, Ua'ola Loko Ike Aloha, love gives life within, reminds us that by loving God wholeheartedly, we love others better. When we develop our relationship with Ke Akua, with Pule, Bible study, and acting upon God's wisdom, we become more compassionate, humble, and supportive. We become kupono people who take the time to listen to others and recognize their uniqueness. We stand up for their well-being and always support those in need. Today's mele, "Lean on Me," tells us that we are the guardians of this place. And through God's love, we can create a culture of belonging. Another way to show what we care for others is by obeying the COVID safety protocols that we have in place here at Kamehameha Schools, Hawaii. Now, I liken these layers of protection to a football player who prepares for a game by putting on layers of protection as a safeguard. You see, once the player's pads and uniform are secure, the last layer of protection is the helmet. Now, the helmet is a significant piece of safety equipment because not only does it protect one's po'o from being injured, it also permits the player to play in the game. Therefore, a fully protected player gets to be involved more. Like the layers of protection that our football player adorns, each COVID safeguard that we obey moves us closer to full participation in school activities. Thus, masking is a must because it deters airborne transmission. Washing or sanitizing hands help us maintain healthy hygiene, preventing germs from spreading by contact. These two layers are the easiest to follow. But we are also being directed to physically distance ourselves from our friends when we socialize with them. This one is tough, and I understand how it happens. But e nā pua o Kamehameha, we can't let our guard down. Football for me has always been a metaphor for life. Players are challenged physically, mentally, emotionally, spiritually, and relationships are tested. So think of the football player who's called by the coach to get into the game. The player bolts from the sidelines, excited to compete, and runs onto the field with joy and purpose. That is until the coach says, "Hey, where's your helmet?" The player is now forced to return to the sideline, still part of the whole team, but not allowed to play that down without the helmet for safety reasons. You see, sometimes we get too excited in the moment and are not focused on our kuleana during the school day. We forget our masks and we stand too close to others while we talk story. This happens. But we all must demonstrate the spirit of aloha and learn from our challenges so we are prepared to fully participate in school. Although I guarantee that football players who forgot their helmets on the sidelines won't make that same mistake again. With COVID, the consequences can be much more stressful. So let us pause together for a moment of silence to reflect on those people and our loved ones who have been stricken with COVID. And in our hearts, let's just ask Yakua to be with them. Mahalo nui. So here are a few recommendations to help us walk on the right path. First one, keep a few more masks with you. That always helps. 2, if it's possible, keep a small container of sanitizer on your person. That'll help. 3, if you're wanting to talk with your parents about vaccination and are of the appropriate age to receive this layer of protection, great. If you're choosing otherwise, great. Then just continue to diligently and intentionally maintain the other layers of protection, because we all belong to a bigger team. Our KS Ohana, our Makua, our Kaiulu, Enapua o Kamehameha. Like Kumushani mentioned, where there's aloha, there has to be evidence of life. Let our actions of love through compliance be that evidence. Finally, I want you to know this. God honors our choices. If we choose God's path for us, God is there. If we choose another path, God is still there, walking alongside and reminding us that all is not lost. What is that right choice? Well, this is where our values from Ke Akua, our Kupuna, our Makua, and our Kula will determine how we prioritize the sacredness of our life and the lives of others. Like Kumu Kenzi taught us, love is an action. Let our actions reveal our love for God with compassionate faith and our love for others with a confident hope, so that we may always lead others with love. We can do this together. Imua Kamehameha.
Ka aina I ohai ai na iwi I ola ka papa o lalo. A hiki aku I kai, ka palena iho o puna me hilo. Kahi I haahaa ka ai a ki e kupono ke kanaka. A hiki ka aina ne e pua pua I mau ai na muo a kako. Velina mai me ke aloha. I hope that each of you are in good physical, emotional, and spiritual health as our Kamehameha Hawaii Kauhale joins together for our opening convocation. Tukahu kauna loa, na hope kahu, and all of our wonderful, talented, and faithful keiki and opio, mahalo piha for your uplifting messages and your reminders of why our kuleana to care for one another by following the layers of safety we have in place, and for your mele reflecting our spiritual theme for the year. Ua ola loko I ke aloha. Love gives life. Brings to mind a mo'olelo many of you may know. Ke kana vai ma mala hoi, the law of the splintered paddle. Among Kamehameha Paiea's greatest accomplishments as a servant leader, the law was enacted in 1782 before he united the Hawaiian Islands. Ke kana vai ma mala hoi protected the weak during times of war, saving thousands of lives. However, the origins of this law to protect life began with him nearly losing his own. In his youth, Kamehameha Paiea grew to be a strong and confident ali'i. One day while traveling along a village coastline in Hilo, he decided to take advantage of a group of fishermen by demanding their catch. The fishermen, who had worked hard all morning, fought back, and in the scuffle, the young ali'i's foot became caught in a lava crevice. The fishermen took full advantage of this delay, striking Kamehameha over the head with a paddle and then fleeing with their catch intact. Our young ali'i was left behind, badly injured by the splintered paddle which lay beside him. Later, feeling the guilt for his mistreatment of the innocent, the now humbled and empathetic Kamehameha proclaimed Ke kana vai ma mala hoi, or the law of the splintered paddle, which declared that all people, especially kupuna and keiki, be able to sleep safely on the side of the road unharmed. Out of aloha for those who raised and reared him, he remembered what they had taught him, that life is sacred, And leadership is a privilege that is earned. Ua ola loko I ke aloha. Because of love for his people and his kuleana to serve those he led, he provided law to safeguard life. Ua ola loko I ke aloha. And with aloha for generations of Kanaka today and those yet to come, this early law from the foundation of Kamehameha Ekahi's kingdom continues to provide a layer of protection for all here. Ua ola loko I ke aloha. E na haumana o meia kauhale. Our strong pilina and care for one another is a layer of protection for each of you. In this kauhale, ua ola loko I ke aloha. May each relationship you have with your huapapa, your kumu, counselors, administrators, coaches, kahu, and most importantly, kia kua manaloa, be rooted in love, strengthened through care, and help you to thrive. Kia aloha nui, ya kakua pau. I mua kamehameha.
Maluno.